G'day everyone. Welcome to the next video update. This one is pretty packed. It covers off on the southwest of WA and we did so much. I'll probably forget a bunch of stuff now, but there's another episode of Australia's Amazing Rocks where we climb Castle Rock and see the granite skywalk in the Porongarup National Park. We go to Green's Pool, another place that we swim, and one of the best places that we've gone to. So scenic, just beautiful. We go to Karri Valley, which is somewhere that Ginny and I actually went on our honeymoon and said at the time it'd be great to bring the kids back here. And we do. We get to paddle around and hire bikes and do archery. It's fantastic. We're into Busselton, up and down the 1.8 kilometre Busselton Jetty. We go to Pentland alpaca farm, which is rated by some people as the highlight of their trip around Australia. I don't know if it's ours, but check it out and see what you think. And probably one of the better things that we've seen along the way, Gnomesville. I will leave you to have a look at Gnomesville and check that out. That's something else. So please, hope you enjoy. If you do, let us know and we'll hook in. Another bright early start to see another amazing rock.
Australia's amazing rocks.
Castle Rock in the Porongarup National Park, southwest WA, near Albany. Not Albany. I said Albany yesterday to a local and I was corrected and told to go back to Queensland. So it's definitely Albany. And we're going to go for a 2 kilometre walk to get to the base of the rock. And then hopefully climb the rock and see the granite skywalk. We'll see how we go.
Let me know, do you feel me too?
Let it show. So, one of the reviews that we saw described this path as relentlessly up. Let's check it out.
We've been on and off, in and out, up and down too many times.
Cannot disagree. All right, here we are. And this is called the Balancing Rock. Yet another of Australia's amazing rocks.
Australia's amazing rocks.
Check it out, hey. What a view.
We're not even at the top.
Yeah. And here we go up to the skywalk. Wow. How good is this, kiddos? Check it out. Woot woot. The skywalk. And you can tell why. My goodness, fantastic. And there's Brookie at the end. Hey, Brookie!
It's so amazing.
Wow. How's the view? Episode of Australia's Favourite Rocks. We're at Castle Rock at the Granite Skywall. How's that view? Now it's time to go back to the kids who are huddling at the start of this because they are not comfortable. Now for the rest of the trip, what comes up must go down. Relentlessly down. Having successfully climbed Castle Rock, seen the Granite Skywalk. Another adventure of Australia's amazing rocks. Here we go. Green pool. My goodness, how nice is this? This looks lovely. When you walked in the door, I could have sworn I've seen your face before. So glad that you said hi, 'cause I was way too shy. What would have happened if you just had passed me by the night? We keep on drinking. Here at, we're at Green Pool. We're at Green Pool, just near Elephant Ross, which is not far out of Denmark, in southwestern WA, probably near Margaret River, and Albany. Not Albany, Albany. And it is just magic. This place is beautiful. It's another place that we've went. That book has been amazing, and can't thank Karri enough for the recommendation. And the kids have just decided to slide down this little rock. But I reckon it looks deep enough for a jump. So let's find out if this is followed by a video of me in an ambulance. It wasn't deep enough, but we'll see how we go. You ready? It was deep enough.
Evie chat.
Where are we, Evie?
We're at Giant.
The Valley?
The Valley of the Giants.
Valley of the Giants. And what are we going to do here, apart from move out of the way of the car?
We're going to go on a treetop walk.
Yeah? You think it'll be good?
Yeah.
Do you know how high up it is?
No, but it's going to be pretty high. Some of these trees are so thick, I can't even wrap my arms around them.
All right. Let's go and have a look. What you're putting in, all your hopes and efforts are all in vain. Who will pick you up when you've lost everything? Does it all become for granted with a wedding?
Off one of those.
Oh, these guys know where their bread's buttered, don't they?
Yeah, that's the fence, tell me that. It's the fence, see this?
No, no, Dad, you need to come in. You need to come in.
I'm freaking out. Oh, it's fine.
Dad, you need to come in.
I'm coming in, mate.
I'm gonna die of fright. This is creepy. I don't like this. Ah!
That is a big pig. Oh, apparently, some Highland cattle.
Out of bed, and I still got you in my head. From all those pretty words you said, it's like I'm wasted. Every time I see your face, I'm losing track of time and space. I don't know where I am. It's like I'm wasted, and I won't waste it. And I promise that I will stand by you forever. I can't get you out of my mind. I will follow you wherever. And I won't waste this.
Oh, Patty, good talk, mate. Well done.
I'll follow you, yeah.
Patty, all right.
I'll follow you, yeah.
Could
closer now, cause I don't wanna slow this down. My heart is screaming out your name, I'm wasted on you. Here we are right underneath the stars, so let's get a little reckless. You make me breathless, and I won't waste this. And I promise that I will stay.
Here we are, these chalets here, apartments, lakeside apartments, where Jin and I spent a few nights on our honeymoon. And now we're back. The drug rats. You want to try and Scottfish. Oh.
I promise that I will stand by you forever.
Go, Evie!
Woo! And I won't waste it. I'll follow you, yeah. I'll follow you,
in Manjimup, and the car's getting some repair work done. And Manjimup is a forestry town, so as part of their, preserving their heritage, they've got this epic playground, the Heritage Park. And the main attraction in it is a big slide, which is modeled off one of the fire lookout towers. So 70 meters up, 91 steps, but you're rewarded with a pretty cool slide. Let's take a look. So this is the view from the top of the slide out over the park, which you can see down there. And there's the slide. Go, Evie, go.
Go,
Evie.
I'm going, okay? Patrick, what's this, buddy?
Tasmanian tiger skeleton.
A Tasmanian tiger skeleton, but we're in Western Australia. So are you telling me that Tasmanian tigers used to live in other parts of Australia as well?
I guess so.
They sure did. And there was one discovered right here in Jewel Cave. Here we go. Down into Jewel Cave.
Evie chat.
So where are we going, Evie?
We are going to an underwater museum or something.
Observatory?
Mm-hmm.
And what town are we in? Busselton?
Busselton, yeah.
So we're going on the Busselton Jetty?
Yeah.
Fantastic. All right.
We're going to go on a little train.
On a little train. Should be fun. Let's go. Check it out. Here we go.
No.
Here we go, kiddos. On the train down the Busselton Jetty.
I got no money, like it or not.
So we're here in Busselton at the moment, on the world famous Busselton Jetty. This is the second longest timber jetty in the world and the longest in the southern hemisphere at just over 1.8 kilometers stretching out to sea, which is pretty amazing. And right at the other end, where we've just been, is an underwater observatory, one of only six in the world that are underneath the jetty, and you can actually go down and check out the man-made reef, the human-made reef that has been constructed by the piles and the piers that hold up the jetty. So absolutely fascinating, and best of all, a cracker day. Absolutely stunning to enjoy this beautiful sight. So far, Busselton on a win. So because the pier's so long, they actually run a train. You can see the tracks. They actually run a train up and down to get everybody out to the observatory and back. And the kids and I have decided to walk back from the observatory. So the challenge is on. Will we beat Evie and Jin, who are catching the train? Let's see. I don't think so. So we've stopped at this place called Gnomesville, which we only heard about yesterday, and when we're getting directions from where we're staying to where we're going, which is Wellington Dam. And the lady giving us directions said, oh, and if you're typical country directions, you know, you take a left at Bob's place and you turn right at the roundabout anyway, and you get to this place called Gnomesville. And you should stop and have a look before you keep going. We thought, oh yeah, sounds quite quirky. Let's have a look. My goodness. There's like 100,000 gnomes here, garden gnomes. All started, I think about 30 years ago, 1989, do the math. They built a new roundabout, and there was a school bus nearby, and one of the mums decided to put a garden gnome in the hollow of a tree next to the roundabout. Somebody else came along and put one there, and here we are in 2023, and I am not kidding when I say I reckon there's at least 100,000 garden gnomes spread throughout the bush near this roundabout now. It is phenomenal, and the funny part is they're garden gnomes, so they're quaint and they're quirky and they're cute and you kind of like them. But when you put tens of thousands of them next to each other, they look like that scene out of The Birds, where all the birds are staring at the family as they tiptoe through and you're just waiting for them to attack you. It's a little bit creepy. Cool, but creepy. So there you go. All the places that you've never heard of, given by random directions, turn left at Bob's place, go along 5Ks and you find yourself at Gnomesville. And here we are in the land of the garden gnome. Cool.